Hello and what is going on today, guys? Tomcat here, and welcome back to more Spin Tires Mud Runner with a Wheel. And as requested, we are going to be doing some hauling with this Ram 3500 Cummins diesel on my wheel. And I'm going to be hauling that particular front loader to the lumber mill. So this is going to be very interesting. I've never driven this truck with a wheel before, and I've never towed with a wheel before either. So I'm very excited to see what could possibly come of this. So I'm going to go ahead and throw the headache rack on the back, as well as the gooseneck hitch, and grab the flatbed trailer and get it all hooked up. So now I'm going to see... I'm debating on whether or not I should have some sort of, like, exhaust stack or something. I kind of want one, but at the same time, I'd rather have the toolbox and then maybe just the regular exhaust. I'm going to have the regular exhaust down where an exhaust usually is. I mean, that one actually is cut off up by the axle. So, the reason why I chose this truck is because it has a full-on interior view, which that means a lot of what we're going to be doing will be interior cam. Now, not all of it is going to be interior cam, but some of it will be. So let's go ahead and grab the... Let's see. This is, I believe, what we're going to work for. Okay. Or work with. So... Why is... Oh, I see. We need to put the marker on, and then we can install the shovel. Should it be a shovel or a grab? Honestly, I almost feel like it should be a grab because we're taking it up to a lumber mill. So we're going to put that on it, and then now we're going to go ahead and get the Dodge in position. So this is going to be interesting because towing with a wheel is something I have never done before, and I can already feel the wheel pulling around. Okay. Let's turn it over to the left here. Because I believe this is the way we would go. I want to say it's the way we would go. Let me look at the map real quick to verify that. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's the way we would go. I mean, I'm sure there's going to be a few little things along the way. There usually are in this game. All right, so let's now... let's drive a little bit further forward, and then we'll go ahead and stop right here. Parking brake on. Ooh, that's not what I wanted. And then we will bring the ramps down. So this is why it helps to use a basically dual input setup, because off camera I have an Xbox controller that I'm basically using to actuate things like the ramps. The diff lock and all that stuff. I mean, I could do some of it on the wheel, but not all of it, and that's why I have a secondary input for that. So this setup is a little unorthodox, but it does work. Oh, come on. Boy. All right, there we go. Loading this up is gonna be fun. All right, let's get that loader raised because I don't want to have to deal with it hooking the trailer. So we'll get back out of advanced mode, and we're going to have to line this thing up. Now, lining it up is probably going to be a little tricky, and it might take a couple of attempts. What's funny is this thing gives, like, almost no resistance on the wheel, probably because it's articulated. Up! Yep. Well, there we go with the whole multiple attempts thing. Easiest thing to do is going to be to recover it in the garage, because I'm not using MudRunner mod with this one. So I'm doing this as you would do it. And I feel like I've never driven like an articulated loader or anything like that, but I feel like, and if someone could chime in in the comments about this, I feel like they probably do have fairly dead steering, because you're not really going to be getting that much feedback, I feel like. Then again, I could be very wrong on that. So let's get you into position. This is so precarious. Stop. This is difficult. This is really difficult. I'm just going to back it all the way up. I'm going to back it all the way up because the second you get that perfect run up the trailer and you get it loaded properly, you're done. But, like, until then, it's all going to be this big game of positioning. Think that's got it. Well, no, because it bounced to the right. This is really difficult, actually. It seems to want to keep bouncing to the right every time I drive it up there. So I'm going to get a little bit more left. And that time it bounced to the left. Okay. Not necessarily my best trailer loading ever, but we're trying our best here with this wheel. I'm trying to get it exactly where it should be. It still ends up basically favoring one side. This is where articulation can help and hurt a rig. Like, articulation is great when you want the maneuverability, but when you're trying to load it up, it can really suck. Is that gonna stay? It might. It might. All right. So, let's see. Before I do anything else, I'll lower that a little bit. And then stop the engine. And swap back to the Dodge. You saw the steering wheel jump when I swapped back into the Dodge. Oh, man. I can feel the weight. Like, I can feel the weight of the steering really, really coming back in. I gotta get it started up. And then, oh god, that's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to get the ramps back up. And they're good to go. All right. So now, our job is simple. Get this to the lumber mill without dumping it. Oh god. So, this is already fairly nerve-wracking, I have to say, because, like, look, I have to keep my hands on the wheel, because it will pull it around. It will 100% pull the wheel around on me. It is definitely a little odd to see the wheel moving on screen and move my wheel, but man, it's weird. I'm gonna grab some exterior footage because my god, this is different. Dude, this is so different. But with that, like, all of that being said, you do have a degree of like a degree of certainty with the amount of steering angle you're putting in. So in some ways, because you have, you know, a proper throttle pedal and you have proper steering inputs, you can be actually really deliberate and gentle with it in a actually kind of a relaxed way. There's none of those jerky controller movements that sometimes make, you know, trailer toes like this kind of sketchy. You can really have the exact throttle position that you want, the exact steering position that you want, but at the same time, you get that feedback that's really nice to have. And you know what I also noticed, and what's really interesting here, is the fact that when I drove this truck beforehand, or at least even just moved it around the parking lot beforehand, the steering was heavier. And then once I loaded up the trailer, the steering at the front actually got a lot lighter once we put the trailer in the back and we put all the weight in the back, which that is very cool. Be easy on the brakes so the load doesn't shift. And let me see where we want to go. Just make sure. All right, so we're going to go left. Going to go left. As far as doing this realistically, I'm trying to do it as realistically as I can. So that's max steering angle. Oh, God. Looking around is a little sketchy. All right, we're into town now. Oh my god. Dude, I look behind and I can see it behind me. That's so crazy. Gee, go in a straight line, please. Go in a straight line, please. Oh my god. All right, let's stop looking around. I'll have some realistic first-person view here. There is absolutely some tension here. I mean, steering's heavy all of a sudden. There is absolutely some tension going on here because you can't see the trailer at all times. And from the limited trailer towing experience that I've had, that is part of the sensation. Like, you feel the trailer behind you, but you can't necessarily see it all the time. Now, mind you, in real life, you have your side view mirrors and your rear view mirrors that you could look around. And now this is a time where I would love to do this in VR. I feel like this would be such a cool thing to attempt in VR that just messing around with it would be so much fun. I'm going to swap back to third person view for a little while because, again, realism is what we're going for here. And I mean, yeah, I know that having the third person view isn't exactly realistic, but I like to be able to go into third person view and check on the load. Now, I wish I could do that while towing a real wow, the steering pulled right there. Like, if I let go of the wheel, look, every time you go over a bump, it does actually move on you. Yep. Just wanted to kind of prove that to the viewers. Now, at this point, yeah, I would probably, you know, just kind of chill right here because that's probably what I would do in real life is I'd just kind of, like, you know, lean back, put my hand up and kind of chill on the main road because you're not really, like, nothing too crazy is happening on the main road. We're actually going to go back into, well, let me check. Whoa! That was weird. The wheel spun on me. That was a little strange. Be prepared for the unexpected. Be prepared for the unexpected in first-person view. Oh, man. It's so immersive once you start to really do this with a wheel. And, like, you have a detailed interior view to look around in, and you have, like, a trailer behind you. It's like, okay, yeah, this feels pretty intense. And whereas before with a controller, you know, where something like this would have just been an everyday task, now it's an actual, like, you know, fairly intense mission. And I love how you have to actually deal with, you know, the same 6-speed automatic that you would have had otherwise. And not only do you have to deal with the 6-speed automatic, which you know, you would normally have in this real truck, but uh-oh. Oh god, we got a low bridge. Ooh, it clipped through a little bit with the light up top, the beacon up top, but oh, that was a little sketchy. That had a little bit of a feeling of sketchiness to it, I gotta say. I have got to say. Trying to kind of split the time between first-person view and third-person view in kind of half and half because I know some people like the first person a little bit more than the third person, but man, like, being able to actually, like, go around and look at what you're doing in third person is really cool, but dude, being in that first-person view, it just feels so cool with the wheel. Like, when you have the wheel and you actually have to, like, picture where the trailer is in your mind, that's something that you never actually, you know, get to do in really any other game, especially with something like this. All right, we're making our way up inside the lumber mill now, trying to unwind the wheel because we are about to head off the road. Ugh. I love that too, how the wheel will actually just wind back for you, like as it actually would in some scenarios if the weight is in the right place. All right, here's our lumber mill, boys. Here we go. All right. So let's go ahead and get stopped real quick. And now, truck isn't carrying any loads, huh? Little do they know. Oh, I want to see. There we go. I need to be able to see the ramps. Let's get the ramps down. Easy. Now the part I've been waiting for. Get this thing started up. And, ooh. Oh my god. Okay, I'm doing this in first person. Easing it back down off the trailer. We got it. Dude, we got it. Oh my god. Dude, that's so cool to be able to do all this in first person. Let's go park this thing. Not only to be able to do this in first person, but to do it with the wheel is so freaking cool. Like, the immersion factor just goes so high. Alright. Let's get some advanced mode stuff going on. Oh, that's not what I wanted. Wanted to lower that down. And then I wanted to try something. Ha ha! Yes! Yes, get out of here! Get out of here! Yes! I don't know why I wanted to do that, but I really wanted to do that. So, that was our first, like, realistic delivery mission. And you know what? Oh, God, it doesn't want to pick those up. I was trying to check. But that was my first attempt at, like, a realistic delivery mission. And, man, that stuff is fun to do. So if you guys enjoyed this video of Spintires Mudrunner with my Thrustmaster wheel, then make sure you click that like button. Tell me in the comments below what y'all thought of it. And if you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe for more. And I will see you guys in the next one. Talk to y'all later.